Friend Mark O'Connor, and last fall it was a great thing. We put together the CMA Awards exhibit in our popular artist gallery, and last night Mark and the O'Connor Family Band had a return performance actually in the MIM Music Theater, which was fantastic. I think another sold out show, and it's the first time Mark has had a chance to see his very own fiddle that is a great highlight of our CMA Awards exhibit. Mark, you can shed a little bit extra light.
Well, we're calling it the Nashville Fiddle because that was the fiddle that I played on all those recordings in the 1980s. And I also played it on, you know, Strength in Numbers. The one I played in Nashville, I played it with the Dregs. New Nashville Cats. On American Music Shop.
From Vanderbilt University in Nashville, Tennessee, welcome to the American Music Shop.
The David Grisman Quintet. Including with Alison Krauss, who you can see on television there.
I'd like to introduce somebody to you who's been probably one of the most influential fiddle players who's ever walked the planet. It's Mr. Mark O'Connor.
Ever win, weren't you? You won when you were what age?
13 years old.
Wow. Isn't that amazing? Probably one of the most gifted musicians in Music City is
Mark O'Connor. No doubt about it. Now, this is...
They tore up the 50s. Old Jerry Lee and Charlie.
She came down from Birmingham on cold summer day.
She'll say things like, "Why have you never told me this?"
Well, in the case of Mark O'Connor, Edgar Meyer, and Yo-Yo Ma, you get a hit CD and a popular tour. This dynamic trio behind Appalachia Waltz joins us now.
Matter of fact, this dobro by Jerry Douglas, I mean, that was basically
his
sound.
Birds of a feather there.
I know. So those, the combination of the two instruments here graced so many albums. A fiddle that I played for a good 10, 15 years. I actually played it on the very first Yo-Yo Ma recording. that, I switched to my next fiddle.
Yeah.
I retired this one, and you good folks here at MIM, the Musical Instrument Museum, asked for it and wanted to display it right here at this beautiful place. So.
Yeah, and when we're celebrating the CMA Awards, to have the very fiddle that Mark really established that reputation in Nashville on so many hit records is really special. Likewise with Jerry Douglas's Dobro here, same era when he was really doing so much studio work, cutting a lot of hits. One of Roy Clark's great Fender Jazz Masters, and Mac McAnally's guitar. So really a range of different instruments, a sweeping history of the CMA Award, so it's really exciting.
I played that fiddle also on Dolly Parton's songs, including Those Memories of You, which we reprised in our O'Connor band.
Yeah, just last night, there was a standing ovation going on. Until the day they lay down. Fantastic to have you here. Mark's become a great fan and a great friend of MIM, and working with people who really make music and sharing their instruments here in the museum is what we always try to do. There's nothing more authentic than an instrument that has been used to make music, to record music that people have listened to for many years, so it's just a great thing.
Interesting points about it. I played this fiddle for about 10 or 15 years, and I helped design this and field tested this original Lloyd Beggs pickup. I said to the Lloyd Beggs company, who were making guitar pickups at that time, I said, if you can make one to the point where I like it, I'll use it. So we went back and forth. This is a microphone that I helped design. I was the first one to use a microphone as an arm extension on a violin. Even before that, when I was with the Dregs, I helped design this jack that used the clamping of a chin rest. To use this jack in the Dregs. And so back then I thought there'd be no interest in any of it. So I'm just really surprised now that so many players use these kinds of systems and inventions to amplify the violin like I used to back then.
Thank you. I think you know that he's going to carry it on. There's something about him that says I'm going to be a musician the rest of my life, and I'm going to do it well, and this is what I care about the most.
Debbie, let me tell you who the musicians were in Telluride. From left to right, it was Bela, Fleck on the banjo, Edgar Meyer on the bass, Sam Bush of Newgrass Revival on the mandolin, Jerry Douglas on dobro, and of course Mark O'Connor, who wrote that tune Bula Bula on the fiddle.